Hi, Carrie here from My Quick Bookkeeping. I have a great question from Tanika. She wants to know, how do you record the sale of gift cards? And then what do you do when people come in and use them to pay for goods or services that you offer in your business? It will require you to set up a new account in your chart of accounts because any funds you receive from the sale of gift card cannot be included in your income until after you actually deliver the products or services to the person who pays with the gift card. Be sure to watch right to the end because I'll flow all the transactions through to your balance sheet and you'll be able to see the result of all your handiwork. Now, let's use the sample company to get this set up. I'm in the US sample company today, and the first thing we'll do is set up an account to post the gift card sale and redemption to. From accounting on the left-hand tab, we can access our chart of accounts. Select new. Category type is going to be an other current liability. This is something that we owe. We haven't yet delivered the goods or services, and we have the funds. Detail type, other current liabilities. Let's name this account gift cards. For the description, I'm going to type gift cards not redeemed, because these are the cards that we have sold to people that we haven't yet redeemed or provided the services for. Save and close. Now I'm going to set up a product to sell. So from the cog, we go to products and services, and we create a new product. Now I'm not going to be tracking an inventory of gift cards, so I'm just going to call this a service. I'm going to call it a gift card. And if you want, you can create different cards for different values. I'm just going to set it up with a default rate of $100. It's definitely not taxable. When you provide selling the gift card, you're not charging tax. You charge the tax when you subsequently provide the goods or services. Now here we have a note that says income account. We're not going to post this to the income account. We're going to post this to that gift cards account that we just set up that will appear in our balance sheet. So here it is. And we can save and close our category. Now let's sell two gift cards. So somebody's going to come in and open up our sales receipt. We don't know who's going to use this gift card, so I've set up a customer called Gift Card Customer. We don't need to track who's going to buy a gift card for somebody else. So we're going to pop down here and we've set up our product and service. So it's a gift card. I'm going to sell two $100 gift cards. As you can see, it's come to $200. I'm popping it in undeposited funds for now. Let's say they paid me cash and I'm just going to pop it in the till and go to the bank later. So let's save this. Look at our balance sheet. So here we are at the balance sheet and we have $200 sitting in our undeposited funds. If we scroll down to the liabilities, we have $200 sitting in gift cards. So now let's redeem a gift card. So our customer is going to come in and they've received one of these gift cards. We'll get our sales receipt and let's see, who is it? We'll say it's Diego. And Diego is going to let's see, what's he going to do? He's going to buy a pump. He's going to buy a pump. And we'll say that this pump is worth $250. I'm going to put tax on it, and he's going to use his gift card to pay for part of it. So here's his gift card. We need to deduct this gift card because he's redeeming it, so the $100 will come off. You can see here that the taxable subtotal is $250. In California, it would be charging at 8%, and then the gift card comes off at just a flat 100 because we didn't collect any tax on it. So I hope that makes sense. If you've got questions about any of that, you can always check with your accountant about the sales taxes in your particular jurisdiction. So now I'm going to save this sales receipt. Let's pop back and see what our balance sheet looks like now. Scroll down here, we can see our gift card balance has dropped down to $100. There are also some rules about what accountants call breakage, and this is where you're allowed to include a percentage of your sales of gift cards in your income to take into account the fact that not everybody is going to redeem their gift cards. I've included a link to a video below just in case you want to know more detail about this. I'm not going to go into it here. Let me know if you have any questions. If this video was useful, please click like below. Subscribe to my channel. I've created a small business month-end checklist that helps you to make sure your books are fully in order at the end of every month. You'll be looking at gift card balances too, possibly. If you click the link below, you can download it and be subscribed to my newsletter. Tanika, thank you so much for your question. And if there's anything else anyone else would like to know about, please do write and make a comment below, and my next video could be for you. Cheers.